Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to our worship service this morning. We're glad you're here again on another cold Sunday morning. I'd like to lift up just a few announcements for you this morning. Following our worship service, we have our administrative board meeting downstairs, and we're going to open it up to all of you. And so after we all get our coffee and goodies, Mick will start the meeting, and we'll get going on that. So PPR meeting will be this Wednesday at 7 o'clock. If you have not heard, Bernice Hermanic passed away a couple nights ago, and her funeral will be on Tuesday at 10:30 here at the church. Our visitation will be Monday from 5 to 7 here at the church, and prayer service at 7 o'clock here. So it'll be messing up my day just week a little bit this week, but just let you be aware of that. The books, we need them to be audited at the end. We're done at the end of the year, so if you have books that need to be audited, please bring them this week and give them to me so the audit committee can start on that. Thursday will be our sewing group meeting, right? I think Betty, and so if you'd like to come help sew on Wednesday or Thursday, that would be great. And then Friday morning, we'll be having our Mitchell Ministry meeting here in Geddes. We'll be the hostess for that. So if you see different cars around here about 9:30 till noon, it's the Mitchell Ministry meeting. So very busy week here at the church. And like I said, my days off kind of got switched a little bit. So I'll be here and there, wherever. So as you know, we are starting our new Bible, favorite Bible person. As you know, we've done our favorite hymn, which is Hymn of Promise, that we sang last Sunday so loud that someone was not here to hear us sing that. But then in Silent Night is our favorite Christmas song. So I want you to take a moment now to look on those. I hope you all vote on that and either tear it off and give it in the offering plate or give it to me after church. But for this week, today, I want you to just take a pin out if you want to do that. Rebecca or Noah, which one of those would you prefer? Some of these you might not know, so you might want to read up on them during the week. But anyway, the next one is Mezuzah, okay, and how you pronounce the other word, Jeff? Okay, see, those two I really have not heard. I've kind of heard about them, but I don't know that much about them. So I had to read up on those. Anyway, then Esau and Delilah. I don't know that much about Delilah, but I heard about Delilah. And then your next choice is Moses or Rachel. So why don't you take a few moments, we're not going to shake hands, but take a moment to vote for the one or the other for now. And then next week, you notice there's the ones above that. You can take the bulletin home and see that. So just take a few moments now and vote for between Rebecca or Noah or those others. And then and of course, we've got to leave Jesus out because we know that he is the giant. He is the number one. But we want to know who is our favorite Bible person in the Bible. So we're doing this for about 15 weeks. So And how are we doing on the funeral wise? Do we need any more help, Betty or Arlene? Do we need any more help for the funeral coming up? Do you need? Okay, all right. So, yeah, if anyone wants to volunteer for the funeral, help out, whatever, get a hold of Arlene or Betty King, maybe today right after church so they kind of know on that. So if you could help out somehow, that'd be great. So. And Linda, do you want to come up and we'll start or prepare our hearts and our minds for worship as we start our worship service?
Our call to worship is found on page 761 in the hymnal, Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Ascribe to the Lord the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in holy splendor.
The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord upon many waters.
The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty.
The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars.
The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon.
The Lord makes Lebanon to skip like a calf, and Syrian like a young wild ox.
The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire.
The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness.
The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh.
The voice of the Lord makes the oaks to whirl and strips the forest bare.
In all general glory.
The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as ruler forever.
May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people.
And now we'll sing hymn number 608, This is the Spirit's Entry Now. And if you could stand if you're able.
Join in unison in the opening prayer. Father in heaven, at the baptism of Jesus in the river Jordan, you proclaimed him your Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit. Grant that all who are baptized into his name may keep the covenant they have made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty God, Lord, now open our hearts and our minds by the power of your Spirit, that as the Scriptures are read and your word is proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today.
The scripture lesson today is found in Acts chapter 10, verses 34 through 43, and the pages are listed in your bulletin. Then Peter began to speak. I now realize how true it is that God does not show favoritism, but accepts men from every nation who hear him and do what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, telling the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. We are witness of everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen. He was not seen by all the people, but by witnesses whom God had already chosen, by us who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sin through his name. The hymn of preparation is number 252, When Jesus Came to the Jordan. And could you please stand? The lesson is found in Matthew 3, verses 13 through 17. The baptism of Jesus. Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John. But John tried to deter him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?" Jesus replied, "Let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this to fulfill all righteousness." Then John consented. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, whom I love, with whom I am well pleased." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Children, come forward and receive the first prayer of Jesus' blessing. Grab one of these just to make sure everyone can hear me.
To you. In Jesus' name, we
was going to give Darcy some pictures to put on the air or on here so you can see, but I was a little afraid what you guys would think about some of those strange pictures of me, so I decided not to do anything like that. So, would you pray with me? Now may Jesus Christ, the King of Glory, help us make the right use of all the merits that God has sent us and offers to Him the true incense of our hearts. For His name's sake, we pray. Amen. Many of you have heard the story about the preacher who wanted to do good things. He wanted to save people's souls. So he was walking on foot between two cities. And he seen a gentleman in front of him. And he knew the gentleman had some problems. He was kind of walking a little funny. He would take a step forward, then he would step over to the side. He would go back a few times. You know, he was doing that so often, the preacher kind of stood and watched him for a while, and I think the man was kind of filled with the Spirit, you could say. But anyway, the preacher went up to this man and said, "Have you ever been baptized?" And the man said, "No." And there was a river about 100 feet from the road, and he took the young man, or the man over there, and he dunked him and for 15 seconds and brought him back up. And he said, "Do you see Jesus?" The man said, "No." So the preacher dunked him again for about 30 seconds and brought him back up and said, "Do you see Jesus?" He says, "No." So the preacher dunked the man for 1 minute in the river and brought him back up and said, "Do you see Jesus?" And the man said, "Are you sure this is where he fell in at?" The world is full of voices. There are voices that speak to me continually and know I am not crazy. There are voices that ring in my ears, my dull ears, from my parents. There are voices that tell me that I was loved and that I'm supposed to be the responsible person that they brought me up to be. There's also voices of Sue that shows both her love and expectations of me as a husband. There are many other voices that people demonstrate from everything from love to compassion to frustrations and rebellions. And there, of course, there are those voices that we hear around the rest of the world. There are voices of our base consumed world that demands we produce more than we buy. There are voices of our peers that entice us to act on values that we know are contrary to our faith and our upbringing. There are voices of advertising that tells us that it feels good to have having more. And you see, wherever we go, we are surrounded by voices. Now, the Gospel of Matthew makes it clear that John really didn't understand that the Messiah would be or produce. John the Baptist did not understand that the Messiah was a humble man who would suffer for his people. And John the Baptist did not understand that the Messiah would not, or came not to condemn, but to save by suffering and dying for them. And at that very time, we see Jesus stood among the crowds, listening to John the Baptist. And others must have thought maybe John the Baptist was the Messiah, because of the way he was acting. But John the Baptist heard these rumors and said, "No, I'm not the Messiah. I'm the forerunner. The Messiah that's coming is whose sandals I don't even untie, like a slave would do for his master." And And then came that dramatic moment when John and Jesus stood face to face. Now remember, they were cousins. And Jesus stepped out of the crowd and laid his mantle against the river banks. And he bowed his head and asked to be baptized. Now John backed away from that and said, "Hey, I need to be baptized by you." But Jesus says, "Let it be so now." Now Jesus added words that hint at the meaning of his baptism. Okay, for he says, "For thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness." And this was kind of the only explanation that the Gospels gives us about this strange baptism. But you see, one thing needs to make clear is that Jesus did not come to be baptized because of any sin. It was true that the other people, the soldiers, the tax collectors came to be baptized. They wanted to be baptized because of the sin that was on their conscience and on their hearts. But Jesus was, however, the first Christian declared in every respect, tempted just like you and I are, but he was without sin. Jesus was sinless. He did need to be forgiven. But what he meant was when he was talking to John about the fulfilling all righteousness was simply this: I must do everything that God requires of every one of us. And Jesus then becomes very humble. And he didn't understand, he did not stand apart from the human race. And looking back at the life of Jesus from his baptism through his resurrection, it can be said that in his baptism, Jesus took the way that would lead him to the cross, where Jesus would go and die for the sins of the world. But at that moment, all of this was hidden and veiled from human eyes. And then it came time for Jesus to be baptized. All the others. Jesus waded into the waters. And he had no doubt that what he was doing was right. And suddenly John baptized him, and all of a sudden the Spirit flashed down upon him like a swoop of a white dove. And then what was echoing in Jesus' ears were from Psalm 2 and Isaiah 42, where the voice from heaven says, "This is my Son, with thee I am well pleased." It was a spiritual experience for Jesus. For years ago, remember when Jesus was 12 years old, he went to the temple, went to Jerusalem for the Passover. His parents were going home and found out he wasn't in the caravan. So he looked for 3 days in Jerusalem for Jesus. And Jesus said to his mom, after they found him, Jesus said, "Did you know I need to be in my Father's house?" And now Jesus heard the voice from God saying, "You are now my Son." Now think and stop about that voice for a moment. This is the same voice that called creation into being. It is that same voice that called Moses and delivered the people, the children of Israel, to the promised land. It was that voice that called and spoken to the prophets of the Old Testament. And this is the voice of which the psalmist spoke: "The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord
if ever there is a voice to be heeded, that's the voice we need to hear. I'd like to close with a saying from Jeff Smith when he writes these words on quote. He says, "I have sought to remind my children from the time that they were very small of something very important. When I drop them off at school or when they leave the house, I leave them with a saying, to remember who they are and who loves them. And I know that during the courses of day, they will hear many voices. They will hear voices to invite them of what the popular kids are doing. They will hear voices that invite others to forget their moral upbringing. They will hear voices to them to do drugs and alcohol. And amidst all these voices, I want them to hear my voice each day, a reminding them who they are." This morning, God is speaking to each one of you. And God speaks to you about it many times. But my question is, what does God want you to do here in Geddes United Methodist Church as we begin this new year? God is calling your voice. And will you accept and hear His voice? No matter what that decision, here in church or maybe at home, would be. The voice of God is calling. Let us pray. O living Spirit, or living God, when the Spirit descended on Jesus at His baptism, in the Jordan's water, you revealed Him as your own beloved Son. You anointed Him with the Holy Spirit. And grant that all who are baptized in His name may keep that covenant that they may have. And boldly confess that Jesus Christ is our Lord and our Savior. And now, our hymn is number 436, "The Voice of God is Calling," and you may remain seated as we stand this hymn, or it's on the screen.
It's the best of your days.
And let us now unite in this historic confession now of our Christian faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Be with those that were wounded.
with knowing that you are a grief healer, and you somehow feel a void for hurting. And again, be with his family, be with all those that are going through a difficult time, maybe an ailment. Again, guide them. And Lord, we lift all this up to you as we join now in the prayer you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And again, we are working on these screens, and we're still working out some of the kinks in there. If you do have a concern or something you want to address to us, please let me or Darcy or even Dave Racy kind of know, or Ross, so we kind of know. Is there a way we tilt the screens a little bit more? Can you just do that? Can you do that a little bit so we can show them what they can do? So we just kind of want you to know what we can do for now, but there's ways we can. Up and down a little bit. We can't go up and down, we just bring them all forward. Okay, so that's kind of what we're doing, and like I said, maybe some of you cannot see the screens, but I hope you can move where you can, and we're hoping that we can get things going on that, but I want to thank the people that put them together. I know me and Chris did Christmas Eve, did a good job of doing that with help, and Ross did the Christmas Day, and Darcy's been working on that for today, and a couple Sundays ago. 3 weeks ago we did that, so thank you. And we're still working out the kinks on that. But if there's any issues you have or whatever, we're still going to have a bulletin, so you and we're still going to have the hymnals, so whatever you feel comfortable doing. So anyway. So again, thank you, Ross, and those that got this all ready to go. And again, I'm like you, we're all learning on this, and so we're going to have some problems here and there, but we'll get things going. So. All right, let's invite us to come forward as we begin our tithes and offerings.
now we stand in awe of your strength, your voice resounding on earth, calling your creatures to obedience and shaping them by your command. May now your words challenge us to arise, to witness to your strength, and to love and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, that Christ is the Lord of all, the only name under heaven that saves. Amen. Receive now the Lord's benediction. The Lord gives strength to the people of God. The Lord blesses them with holy peace. Depart now with joy and courage. Depart with confidence and peace. And go in the name of Jesus. Amen.
From above.